his opponents just entering the ring, out of Aikido, Japan, weighing in at 230 pounds, it's Akio Sato. This is a one fall, 10-minute time limit. Your referee, Gary DeRuscia.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall along with Ray the Triple Stevens, and this is AWA Action. Tarzan out of Philadelphia. The jungles of Philadelphia, no doubt. In there with Akio Sato from Aikido, Japan. Already Sato going to work on Tarzan.
That'd be a very interesting match, Lee. This Tarzan, a big, strong-looking guy.
Yeah.
Sato, one of the finest from Japan.
Tarzan's taking notice right away that he is indeed a strong man, picking up Akio Sato with a body slam into a headlock, grinding away right away on Tarzan's head. Into the ropes goes Tarzan. Dropped down by Sato. Off the ropes comes Tarzan. Whoop! Right back into that headlock. And a right hand by Akio Sato. Ooh, what a shot! And that sends Tarzan right down.
I tell you, he's a master at that chopping. When he chops you, brother, he can drop you like a two-foot putt.
I'm telling you. Body slam followed by a boot right into the throat area by Akio Sato. Sato's a quick worker.
Yes, he is. He's a tremendous wrestler. The people that haven't seen him before, he's got a very mean streak in him, and
oh, yeah.
He really goes after people.
Yeah, he's one of those kind of guys. He realizes that wrestlers don't get paid by the hour. He wants it done with and done with as quickly as he can. He's working right away on Tarzan's face, trying to rearrange the facial features of the youngster out of Philadelphia. Another chop.
I'll tell you what, when he can take a big man like that off his feet, he's got some power behind a chop like that, Lee.
Reversal. Sato into the turnbuckle. Oh, man!
Oh. What a devastating kick right in the face.
Gary DeRuscia says, I saw it, and it was clean, and it was. What a heads-up move by Akio Sato. Into a standing arm ringer. Face first into the kick. Oh, man.
That could have dislocated that shoulder very easily.
And right away, Sato back to work on the left hand. Oh, look at that. A nerve hold being applied by Akio Sato, a master of the martial arts. Gary DeRuscia is going to ask if he wants to give it up. He says, yeah. Tarzan's had enough. Now DeRuscia trying to get Akio Sato off the man. And a winner by submission. There he is, Akio Sato.
Boy, he put that claw hole on like I've never seen it put on before, right under the arm. He had to get those nerves. He put him away in a hurry.
Oh, he sure did. A devastating hold and a big win for Akio Sato. Wow.
More wrestling action in a moment, ladies and gentlemen. But if you missed it last week on ESPN, you're looking at the new tag team champions of the world, the Olympians, Brad Ringens and Ken Patera. Brad, it's got to be the thrill of a lifetime.
Larry, this is the biggest moment in my wrestling career, to win the AWA World Heavyweight Championships with my partner, Olympic strongman Ken Patera. And I want to take this opportunity to thank all those people out there that believed in us, that we could do it. I have to leave for Japan right now, Larry, to go for the World Cup title. But when I return to the U.S. of A., my partner and I will put those titles up against any tag team.
There you go, Bradley. You know, I've held these belts before with Jerry Blackwell, but I can't think of a greater partner and a greater honor than Brad Ringens being my new tag team partner. I'm going to be in Loyal. Brad's going to be in Japan. But another person that's held these belts before, too, Greg Gagne, will be my partner against Bad Company. Then I'm going to go over to Toma. I'm going to be at Shano. I'm going to be all over the place. I'll blanket the whole Midwest defending these belts with my buddy here. Gets back from Japan.
Bad Company, screaming bloody murder. They'll be looking for you when you get back from Japan, Brad.
They'll be looking for another excuse, Larry, but there ain't gonna be any room for excuses this time, Bad Company. We showed you one time, and we'll show you again.
Get ready in Loyal, in Shano, and in Toma for the tag team champs.
Friday, April 21st, you're going to see some tremendous action. Wahoo McDaniels on the card, as is Bad Company, Paul Diamond and Pat Tanaka. Then Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School, get ready for some of the greatest wrestling action you have ever seen, including AWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Larry Zbysko. That's Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School at 8 p.m.
Hey.
gentlemen, introducing out of Dallas, Texas, the AWA Ladies Champion, Wendy Richter. This is a one fall, 10-minute time limit, and your referee, Marty Miller.
And this is for the Ladies Championship of the World, Wendy Richter. She's had that strap of gold around her waist no less than five times. In there with Shirley Black from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall and Ray Stevens. And here we go. Championship-style wrestling on the AWA. Quick takedown by Wendy Richter. Down goes Shirley Black. And already, Wendy with that powerful headlock, Ray.
You bet. Took it right to her. Wendy Richter is a tremendous wrestler. If she wasn't, she wouldn't have the championship.
Five times.
Five times, and she's a big, strong gal and can move like a cat. I'm very impressed with her wrestling.
Absolutely. Shirley Black in there challenging for the championship of the world, and Wendy Richter still cranking on that headlock. Shirley Black, also a big girl from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Interesting that Wendy Richter from Dallas, Texas, two girls from basically the same part of the country. Shirley Black trying to escape that headlock. Wendy says, no, I got you. Into the ropes goes Wendy Richter. Side leapfrog, scoop down, in for a pin, two.
That was pretty close.
Sure was.
Good move by Wendy Richter.
Yeah, you got to look pretty high and low to find somebody that thinks as fast on their feet as Wendy Richter. Another reason why she is the champion of the world. Knee into the midsection by Wendy Richter, and she's already got Shirley Black rocking. Roll up by Wendy Richter. One, two, kick out by Shirley Black. Another thing about Wendy Richter, just if you look at her face, she's got so much determination, so much concentration. I mean, she is in the match from the opening bell all the way to the finish.
Oh, absolutely. Surprisingly, too, being the champion, she's very offensive. She takes it right to him, doesn't back up a bit.
That's true, because it is said that in order to be the champ, you got to beat the champ.
That's right.
And when you're the champ, I suppose you can afford to be a little defensive. Wendy Richter does not wrestle that way. She comes at you all guns loaded from the opening bell. Still working on that headlock, Wendy Richter and Shirley Black. Wendy with the advantage. Into the ropes goes Wendy Richter. Oh, man. Again, you talk about being reactive. Wendy Richter, slingshot. And there goes Shirley Black across the ring. Oh.
Well, you can see the mean streak coming out in Wendy Richter.
One, two.
Good almost strong. Almost got the cameraman there.
Good strong kick out by Shirley Black. Everybody enjoying the action here. Rochester, Minnesota is where we're coming to you from tonight. Ooh! Shoulder into the midsection by Wendy Richter as Wendy climbs back into the ring. She's looking to tangle up with Shirley Black, and there's that determination I'm talking about. Just look at her face. I mean, certainly she's a pretty girl. But Wendy Richter is all business all the time.
Just keep right on that headlock, too. She's thinking, yep. That's a nice move.
Very nice. Into a head scissors by Shirley Black. Marty Miller, the referee, he's going to check and see if it's a choke. It is not. It is a clean scissors by Shirley Black, and she's putting the pressure on Wendy. Wendy trying to bridge out of it, and Shirley Black says, nah, take one of these, right from the midsection. Wendy's still trying to kick out a third time. Being the charm, Wendy Richter's out of the scissors. Boot to the back by Shirley Black. Forearm to the back of the neck by Shirley Black. And Wendy Richter, her bell has been rung a little bit here, Ray.
Yes, it has. No doubt about it.
Clothesline, and down goes Wendy Richter. Be a great opportunity for Shirley Black. The belt is on the line tonight. We could see the title change hands. Right into the throat, now into the midsection. Shirley Black working forearms on the champion, Wendy Richter. Marty Miller saying, back it off, girl, back it off. Open up those hands, no fists.
They're getting right after it, Lee. I'll tell you that. It's been a good match.
Oh, yeah. Moved into the midsection by Wendy Richter. Reversal into the ropes goes Richter. Leapfrog by Wendy off the ropes. Drop kick that misses.
Oh.
Anybody that's seen Wendy Richter wrestle knows that's one of her favorite maneuvers. It didn't work that time. Scoop of the legs,
minutes.
Though. Nice
Elias
recovery by
time.
Wendy.
Five
slingshot,
minutes.
And down goes Shirley Black. What a spectacular recovery by Wendy Richter, and again, back into that standing headlock. belly to back.
Wow, what a move, what a move.
That's all. Some confusion in the ring. Wendy Richter gets the Duke.
Shirley Black thought she had won that. She thought she had the
Ladies
title right there.
Wendy had her shoulder
your
up.
Your winner in
and
5 minutes
Wendy taking the position on time,
seconds.
It was Wendy that was able to put the
Wendy
shoulders of Shirley Black
Richter.
Down. Marty Miller explaining it to Shirley.
Richter, your winner.
Well, that's what makes you the champion, Lee.
You bet.
Nails the team.
A lot more wrestling action coming up this week, ladies and gentlemen, but you fans in Loyal and in Shawano and in Toma, you have the opportunity to see the AWA live. Get down to the arena. One of the combatants will be the heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Zbyszko, quite nattily attired this week on All-Star Wrestling.
Listen, I want to illustrate a point to the Spudheads, Larry, because there's two types of people in life. We have winners and we have losers. And we've had great losers through history, with like Judas, and of course Benedict Arnold, Jim and Tammy Baker. Now Wahoo McDaniel, he's a loser because he's an Indian, and the Indians shoot their mouths off, but they're the biggest losers in history. For God's sake, you charge with the cannons and rifles with bows and arrows, and I'm supposed to worry about Wahoo McDaniel in Jerkwater, USA, and Ken Patera, world's strongest man, can't figure out why he still can't beat the world's greatest wrestler. Because we're not lifting weights, Spudhead. We're wrestling. And I'm a winner. I'm like Clint Eastwood and John Wayne. You know, when men were men, our word is truth, our checks don't bounce, our women keep their mouths shut. And the whole point of it is that Larry Zbyszko is the winner because he's the best wrestler in the whole damn world. And Patera, Wahoo, Ganya, the others, they're just Spudheads with a dream.
Yakisuzu, the right choice.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall along with Ray the Crippler Stevens. And well, before we get going on this, it looks like we've got somebody else going to be joining us at ringside here. None other than the luscious one, Johnny Valiant.
Well, how you doing there, my friend? This is luscious Johnny Valiant here at ringside. Certainly be glad a part of the AWA.
Good to have you back in the AWA, Johnny, and I'm going to get right down to business with you. We know that your return to the AWA does mean business, and we can only presume that you're here looking at one, if not perhaps a number of wrestlers that you would like to manage.
Well, as I watch the current AWA champion, Larry Zbyszko, in the ring, I come here as a wrestler. I come here as a manager.
Right.
I'm looking for talent. There is a lot of talent here in the AWA. Right now, Larry Zbyszko is at the top of the heap, if you will. Some people have said I'm here to manage Larry Zbyszko. Other people say I may be here to manage Greg Gagne. I mean, only time will tell as we see Larry Zbyszko certainly his opponent.
Well, what are you saying, Johnny? Is what you're saying the fact that you're not going to say anything at all?
I think you hit the nail on the head there. You make that John Tower investigation sound pretty fair dinkum to me.
Nice fireman's carry by Larry Zbyszko, the living legend, the champion out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Now, when you say the living legend, does he more or less refer to himself as the living legend, or is that the wrestling fan's analogy of
Larry
Zbyszko? I know. I've wrestled Larry Zbyszko.
I understand you have, Johnny. I
many
understand
times
it's also
around the East Coast.
A self-proclaimment on the part of Larry Zbyszko.
You see,
I don't
the
think
difference...
the fans have given him that moniker.
Let me just say this. That Larry Zbyszko can back up what he says. You see, that's the difference of guys like... say a Gagne, you know, they pop their mouth off this
whoa,
and that.
Whoa,
you know.
Johnny, come on.
I have to establish, look at that kick. Look at that. You see that?
I'm going to give you credit
like
for
stuff
credit
like that.
Due, but gee whiz, Johnny, Greg Gagne is the international television champion. I mean, you've got to give credit where
it's
due.
Look at this. Ooh, look at this. Upside down.
Bam.
Grandma.
Wow.
He's looking at the moon, okay?
Yeah, you got
Larry
that.
Larry Zbyszko could beat this guy at any time, okay?
Well.
He's just toying with him. And I like that, you see? I like that in a wrestler. That's why Larry Zbyszko is the champion.
Well, it has been said and has been proven in the fact that luscious Johnny Valiant makes champions. Would you want to take over the career of somebody who is already an established champion?
I very well may put the magic dust, if you will, on a tag team.
Why can't you just come straight up with me?
Why can't you
Why
catch the drift of the conversation and shut up and let me out here
I am following the drift of the conversation. I think
you know, you're a very boring individual, you know
come
that.
On, Johnny.
In fact, you know, they put your brain in a canary, it would fly backwards, you know that.
Everybody knows you're here scouting talent. Why can't you just be straight up and honest about it and admit that you're here to
see Larry Zbysko, Greg Gagne, the Top Guns, or who knows? Why can't you just say who you're here to see?
Listen, in the upcoming weeks, I will divulge, and the people will emphatically see my presence in the AWA, why I'm here, okay?
All right.
Let's just sit back and watch Larry Zbysko, the AWA champion, annihilate this punk.
Well, there's something to watch when you see the AWA heavyweight champion of the world. I cannot take anything away from, nor will I ever take anything away from, the living legend, Larry Zbysko, self-proclaimed or not. He is, as Johnny Valiant has said, what he claims to be. Wow! Rams rocking Randy right into the turnbuckle. Right hand by Larry Zbysko.
So far, this guy is a rocking Randy. He's been getting rocked everywhere, every way but turn loose up there in that ring so far. He hasn't shown me nothing. This guy's a complete half-wit of a moron, a poor excuse for a professional wrestler.
Gary DeRusha trying to get Larry Zbysko back.
What a way, Larry. Just keep pounding away. Torture this half-wit.
Another forearm by Larry Zbysko.
Nice. That was beautiful. Music to my ears.
I'll tell you who's doing a lot of the talking is Zbysko and referee Gary DeRusha. DeRusha trying to back him off of this young man, and it's not doing any good, Johnny.
One, two.
He did make the kick out. Randy, rocking Randy is loose. Two count. Zbysko setting him up. Going for the pile driver. Oh, he's got it. Oh, man, he planted him. Oh, gee.
Out of the way, Larry. That away. See how he just hopped up there? You see that beautiful little maneuver? He hopped up there. You got half the people walking around the streets can't even do the maneuver that Zbysko just did right there, brother.
DeRusha could count to 100 if you get down there and pin him.
He could count to 5,000. One, two, three. Sell the farm.
Well, I don't know if you're out here to see Larry Zbysko or not, Johnny, but you have to be impressed with what you saw tonight.
I'm not surprised because Larry Zbysko shows me a lot. He has over the years, and here goes the
Ladies
victory right now to Larry Zbysko.
Your winner, 4 minutes and 30 seconds.
Well, I don't know if it has
legend,
been a pleasure, but it
Larry
certainly has been
Zbysko.
Interesting. Luscious Johnny Valiant back in the
Zbysko,
AWA. And he saw what you saw. The living legend, Larry Zbysko, with the win. And here it is, Johnny. Look at this pile driver.
Beautiful
Bam.
Pile driver. It's lights out right here. Sell the farm. Go get your insurance policy out right now. There it is, Larry Zbysko. He knows what that spells. It's a victory.
We'll get back to the wrestling action in just a moment, ladies and gentlemen. Great wrestling action this week. But first, I've got a real treat for you fans of athletes everywhere. We're going to bring a world champion out here. A lot of you are familiar with this young man and his many accomplishments. But for those of you who aren't, we're going to get Scott the Flash Norton to step out here. This man is the arm wrestling champion of the world. And Scott, before we do anything else, I want the fans to be able to take a look at this massive arm. Can you get... Yeah, see, it completely blots me out, Scott. I got to ask you, before I ask you anything else, about the size of this arm.
That's about 23 and a half inches.
23 and a half inches. Now, I know you're a lot taller than I am. How tall are you, Scott?
I'm 6'3", 360 pounds.
360 pounds, ladies and gentlemen. Vern Gagne has called this young man one of the greatest young prospects ever to come into professional wrestling. But before we talk about that, Scott, let's talk about your other qualifications. First of all, obviously, in arm wrestling, you are the world champion.
Yes, I'm the world champion, four-time national champion, and I've been training for a lot of years to do it. And,
you made it. Who did you beat to win that? Who did you beat to win that title?
I beat Cleve Dean, who was 6'8", 660 pounds.
Now, I want to make sure you understand that, ladies and gentlemen. He's not kidding. 600 and how many?
60 pounds.
660. That's the man this guy beat to become the world champion. Your local background now, where were you born and raised?
I've been living in Minneapolis all my life and stayed here as long as I've been.
And you have been doing quite a bit. Well, coming up, you participated in quite a few athletic endeavors.
Oh, yeah, I've been playing football in high school and college. And then I currently bench press in the Nationals last year, and I did a 660 for the national championships.
That's what I want to get into, the weightlifting. Now, you third in the world ever, as I understand it.
Yeah, third all time at 660 pounds, and currently it's a 705-pound world record. I'd like to go up to that pretty quick myself.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about a man who's the arm wrestling champion of the world, who has held weightlifting world championships, and who now is moving into professional wrestling, and that is a big deal, Scott. That's the toughest sport I know of.
It's the hardest train ever done in Brad Reagan's school of worldwide school of professional wrestling. It's been tough.
Ladies and gentlemen, this young man is a tremendous prospect. You're looking at one of the greatest athletes in the world, Scott the Flash Norton. ladies and gentlemen, I have the opportunity to introduce you to the newest member of the AWA broadcast team. Now, you may have seen this young woman on posters throughout the United States, on national television commercials. You may have seen her any number of places. And now, from now on, she will be hosting the Matt Classic. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet Nori Helm.
This week's Matt Classic is being brought to you by Mars.
Thanks, Larry. Great to be part of the AWA. Today, we're going to take a look at a wrestler who's a former rodeo star. He's best known as a trucker, a fighter, and a wild bull rider. We'll be right back in a moment. Stay tuned. Between Ray the Crippler Stevens and Red Bastien. Now, at one time, both of these wrestlers were both co-owners of the AWA's Tag Team Championships. We're going back today to 1972, where they're in the ring in singles competition. So let's go back and take a look.
I've seen you destroy
quite a while there. But you know, everybody I wrestled, they knew better than to just bail on me, no matter if I was down or anything, because they knew I could reach out and grab something and I was capable
of. Well, Luce, you were shaking your head and opening your eyes. Red's gone. Red's out. Oh, he's starting to move around a little. No, I don't think Red's opened his eyes yet. There we go.
When you get hit that hard, I mean, it takes you a while to get tuned back in on the world.
Oh, yeah.
And we've been going at it for some time here, and we both, you can see that we're tiring here.
One, two,
still reach down there and have some power. I'm telling you, he's Red had a heart the size of a basketball.
And a head pretty hard. Oh, I was going to say headbutt, but knocked you out. Looked like he knocked himself out. Probably not the best thing that Red could have done at the time. You do what you think is right at the time.
That's right. Oh, if I remember right, I came out of this match, I had a broken nose.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised if that was the move that broke it right there, Ray. And there you put, wow. Well, you launched Red. You launched him.
I was trying to.
You and Red just outside the ring. I think at this point, you've both abandoned any idea of who was going to win, just who was going to hurt the other guy. Wait a minute. What's the decision? Double count out. All that work for a double count out, Ray?
Well, Red lost his temper a lot there, and he made a mistake. Now, if he'd have been thinking and jumped back in that ring.
This was so neat. Red Bastien and Ray Stevens, and that's our Mad Classic.
Ray Stevens survived this match and many more matches like it. Most recently, he's been sidelined by a knee injury, and he's now a part of our broadcast team. Join me next week for another great Matt Classic. We'll see you then.
This week's Matt Classic. April 21st is the date. Wrestling fans in and around Loyal, Wisconsin, you get ready. Friday, April 21st, you're going to see some tremendous action. Wahoo McDaniel's on the card, as is Bad Company, Paul Diamond and Pat Tanaka. Then Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School, get ready for some of the greatest wrestling action you have ever seen, including AWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Larry Zbysko. That's Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School at 8 p.m.
On his way to the ring right now, the mercenary from South Africa, accompanied by one of the other many Diamond Dials, Suzanne, at 131 kilos. Attention! Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very special wrestling match. Colonel DeBeers has said that if he cannot pin Tommy Jammer in 10 minutes or less, that he will give the young man from California $2,500 of his own money. From California, ladies and gentlemen, brother, your history. Marty Miller is your referee. At ringside, Lee Marshall and Ray Stevens.
Thank you very much, Larry. Well, this is going to be a most interesting match. It's got a 10-minute time limit, and that is by design. Colonel De Beers from South Africa says, if I cannot pin Tommy Jammer in 10 minutes, I will give him $2,500.
Well, I tell you what, Lee, I think De Beers might have bit off more than he could chew here. This Tommy Jammer is a fine athlete and a fine wrestler and one whale of a specimen of a man.
Oh, you bet he is. They grow big in San Diego, California. A little partial to California.
Well, I am, too.
Oh, that's true. That's true. You know, the hottest fad in California is now from San Diego. It's a place called Uncle Biff's. Uncle Biff's is a cookie store. And everybody in California is now eating Uncle Biff's cookies. I don't know how or why fads start, but it does. And they all start in California, as we know. Oh, wow, man. De Beers planted him like a tree. Secret. Wow. Anybody who would ever question the strength of Colonel De Beers, Ray, hadn't had to look any further than that last move. Snap mare. Whoa.
Well, I tell you what, he's a wrestler. What we call a salty man in our business.
You bet. This isn't a 30-minute, a 45-minute, or an hour. There's Diamond Dallas Page, the manager of both the Diamond Exchange and Colonel De Beers. Oh. Colonel De Beers has only 10 minutes. 10 minutes in which to pin Tommy Jammer. And he says that if he can't do it, Jammer wins $2,500. Drop down by Jammer. Shoulder tackle, and again down goes Tommy Jammer. Look at De Beers just standing over him.
I don't know how many of those he can take.
Not many. There's one of the Diamond... Ooh, the Diamond Dolls. Hello. Standing headlock by De Beers. Marty Miller, the third man in the ring tonight, trying to keep law and order in a match that could be $2,500 for Tommy Jammer. All he's got to do is stay in the ring for 10 minutes with the Colonel, and that's not an easy task.
Tell you what, the Colonel better take it to him a little harder right now.
You bet.
He's only got 10 minutes to do it, and that's not very long with a man in there like Tommy Jammer.
Well, you had it called, a knee to the midsection by Colonel De Beers. Again, a knee to the midsection of Tommy Jammer. And I don't care how well-muscled you are, when a knee comes flying into your midsection, baby, you are going to feel it, and you are going to lose your breath every time. Standing headlock. Snapmare. Down goes Jammer. Walking around the ring, proud as a peacock as always, Diamond Dallas Page, the manager of Colonel De Beers. There he is.
That's right, baby. He's just toying with a man. Just a matter of moments before he puts him away.
$2,500
right
back
in our
pocket. You got any certs? Chloraseptic, Listerine.
I'm glad he was talking to you.
Oh,
he looked like he was spitting on you.
Oh, God. I mean, I like Diamond Dallas Page. I got to draw the line when it comes to bad breath.
Hammer's taking it to the Colonel right now.
You bet he is.
With the top wrist lock.
You're wondering how to break it. That's a way to do it. Another mid-knee into the midsection by the Colonel. Elbow right into the back of the neck by Colonel De Beers. He's got Jammer rocked.
You'll notice this is changing the Colonel's style a little bit. He's being much more offensive than he normally is. He normally lays back there.
Ooh. Wow. Well, like you said, Ray, he's only got 10 minutes to get it done. 10 minutes. I mean, this isn't a one-hour time limit. This is 10 minutes and $2,500 on the line. If he can't put this young man from San Diego away, it's going to cost him American money, not that South African stuff. $2,500 American.
Oof. I wouldn't want to call him Colonel Chief or anything, but I heard he's pretty close with a dollar. You know, $2,500 would break his heart.
Oh, yeah. But he's got a man. Ooh,
oh, man. An arm drag.
Tommy Jammer just caught the Colonel. You talk about an arm drag. He had that sunk all the way in, into an arm wringer. And Jammer has got the Colonel in a world of hurt.
Yes, he has. I tell you what, Jammer's very impressive. He's been wrestling defensive there and taking quite a beating up to this point.
I think Tommy Jammer just came to realization what kind of payday he could have. All he's got to do is stay in the ring for 10 minutes. He'd love to beat the Colonel, but all he's got to do is stay in there with him. De Beers says he can beat him, he can pin him, he can put him away in 10 minutes. Well, look at it now, the advantage, Tommy Jammer from San Diego. Reversal by De Beers, very nicely done, a reversal by Jammer.
Oh,
whoa, what a takedown. Oh, wow.
I'll tell you what, the Colonel's in trouble. If Jammer stays on that arm's going to be pretty weak.
No, got to give it up. No.
Elapsed time. 5 minutes, elapsed time.
Dick Jankowski reminding us 5 minutes are gone, only 5 minutes left, one of the diamond balls. Telling Colonel DeBeers, come on, Colonel, you're halfway through.
It's not looking good. The time is down to 5 minutes, and Jammer's got the advantage right now.
Well, it's the old adage, you know, how positive do you want to be? Is the glass half full or is the glass half empty? Regardless, it's half gone. 5 minutes are gone in this match. Boot to the midsection by Tommy Jammer. Into the turnbuckle. Shoulder first goes Colonel DeBeers, and Tommy Jammer is on him like a coach.
Wow. Still on that arm. Very, very impressive.
And again, cranking the pressure on.
I tell you what, Tommy Jammer's in there with an experienced veteran, one of the top wrestlers in the world today, and he's doing one heck of a job.
Well, I think Tommy Jammer is making a statement.
This young man has arrived. 6 minutes.
Six minutes now gone. 4 minutes left. A very worried and concerned Diamond Dallas Page, and why not? One of the Diamond Dolls saying, come on, get up. Only 4 minutes left. All Jammer's got to do is hang out there for 4 minutes.
I think I know what the Colonel's strategy is. He's thinking, well, I'll get him breathing pretty hard here. Whoa.
Over the top rope. Now you have to figure if that was momentum that took him or deliberate.
That was momentum.
Marty Miller. Yep, Marty Miller making the right call. Colonel DeBeers lining him up, jumping up. Boot right into the top of the head. And Tommy Jammer, he is in trouble.
Anytime you hit that concrete like that,
yep,
Lee, it's got to hurt you.
The Colonel's starting to look real good now.
That arm's still bothering him, though. I'll guarantee you that. Oh,
another boot right to the side of the head, right into the ear. Another shot into the ear. Diamond Dallas Page saying, come on, Colonel. Let's get it done. But here comes Tommy Jammer. He's still in there.
Seven minutes gone.
3 minutes to go. Colonel DeBeers has got to do something in 3 minutes. Oh, and he did. Oh, man.
Side suplex there. That put the hurt on Tommy right there.
One, two, kick out. Well, that's where conditioning comes into play, Ray. When you can take a punishing hold like a side suplex, which had to knock the wind out of you, and then be able to kick out of it. Looking for it again.
What
a nice move by Jammer. He's going to reverse it on DeBeers. Belly to back suplex, and DeBeers is rocking.
Super move by Tommy Jammer, and you hope he doesn't make a mistake here.
Jammer going for the top rope. Marty Miller telling him to get down. Jammer on the top rope.
So often you see the younger wrestlers do that and make a bad mistake when
you're
in there with a veteran, get a little bit
overconfident.
8 minutes gone now, Ray. Only 2 minutes left, and Tommy Jammer, I don't like his chances now. Going for that high-risk maneuver. Boot to the throat by Colonel DeBeers.
I tell you, he's strong. He's a strong young man. If he can hold on just another minute or two, he's got 2,500.
Well, I don't know if he's got another minute or two. Colonel, and down goes Tommy Jammer. Diamond Dallas Page saying, nicely done. Talking now to Tommy Jammer, saying, give it up, boy. One. A count of two, and Jammer kicks out.
I tell you, the Colonel better pour it on if he's going to beat him.
Marty Miller warning him about using the hair. Going again for the side. Oh, the backbreaker. DeBeers going for the pin.
He might have
two.
It.
Two.
He kicked out. I'll tell you what, Jammer's got a lot of try, brother.
Nine minutes elapsed time. 9 minutes.
1 minute left. Only one minute left. DeBeers is getting a little frantic. He's only got 60 seconds in which to put this young man away.
Pile driver.
This could be it.
45 seconds remaining.
45 seconds left.
He better be on him in a hurry.
Tommy Jammer just able to get his foot over the top rope. Boot to the head. Diamond Dallas Page telling them, come on, Colonel, we got seconds left to get this done.
30 seconds.
Only half a minute left. He's got him, Ray.
Oh, he's got him back. He's doing good.
Oh!
There's a kick out. The power of Tommy Jammer. He's a big, strong man. He kicked right out of that.
What power by Tommy Jammer.
15. 14. 13. 12.
12 seconds.
11.
10 seconds.
9.
He's up.
8. 7, 6 seconds. 5.
I can't believe
4,
it.
3.
He won't get it.
And he didn't get him. He didn't get him.
He didn't get him.
He did not get him. Jabber stayed in there for 10 minutes. Only a two count, says Marty Miller. He did not get him.
I'll tell you what, the Colonel was probably one sad man right now.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And there's Marty Miller with the money. $2,500 to Tommy Jabber. Tommy Jabber wins $2,500.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he did what Colonel Levere said he couldn't do, and that was stay in the ring for 10 minutes with
did
him.
Did not.
Well, I tell you what,
Tommy Jabber,
that was very
in the
interesting, and the Colonel just bit off more than he could chew there. And that
Colonel Levere pays $2,500.
Oh, Colonel Levere is blindsiding Jabber, and he's going after him. He's going after
Colonel
him,
Levere. Paid $2,500 to Tommy Jabber.
There's money all over the ring. Marty Miller, the referee.
Pile
driver right into the cement floor here in the arena. Marty Miller telling the referee, or Marty Miller, the referee, asking for the bell to be rung again. Colonel Levere grabs the money back from Marty Miller. Diamond Dallas Page taunting Tommy Jabber, but Tommy Jabber did in fact stay in the ring for the required 10 minutes. I don't know what Colonel Levere thinks he's doing. He lost that $2,500 as sure as you and I are sitting here, Ray.
Well, it looks to me like he...
Here comes Derrick Dukes! Here comes Derrick Dukes!
Hey, yeah.
He throws a drop kick! He throws another drop kick! He caught him on that one!
He stole the money! He's running! He's going
Dukes has got the money! Derrick Dukes has got the money, and DeBeers, Colonel DeBeers, is over the, he's over the side. Let me find out what the heck is going on here.
Well, DeBeers is down. He's out for the count. He is hurt. Derrick Dukes left with the money. Tommy Jabber looks hurt. Very hurt. There goes Tommy Jabber out of the ring with the aid of Ricky Rice and the referee, Marty Miller. Colonel DeBeers don't look very well himself right now.
Let's find out what in the world happened here. The first thing that we need to establish is Diamond Dallas Page, your man has lost $2,500 because he did not defeat Tommy Jabber in 10 minutes. You have lost $2,500.
Think I really care about $2,500? I got money I haven't folded yet. Well, first of all, we don't care. We don't care about the $2,500. Where did that Top Gun come from?
What are you talking about?
What is that Top
Gun? Who hit me?
Top Gun, Sport Gun, what Derrick Dukes came out of nowhere.
Derrick Dukes came in and...
He shot him. Came out of nowhere.
He's Derrick Dukes! Yes, Derrick Dukes.
The black camper!
Well, the black wrestler.
He's a camper! No, man! That man shouldn't even be allowed to breathe the same air with Colonel Levere.
Wait, Kurt. Look out. You better control your man. The fact that a black man.
He has everything. He has every right to be defended, man. He came out of nowhere and cheap shot at him.
Well, whether or not he cheap shot.
$2,500. He stole the $2,500.
He did not steal. He did not steal $2,500 from anybody. Look.
You were right there. You saw him pick up the money.
What?
There's only one thing I want. I want that Kaffer for just 10 minutes. You already beat Jabber.
Now, wait a minute, wait. What? If you're going to put another $2,500 on the line, you're running out of money, pal.
No. I've got money I haven't even folded yet. I want that Kaffer. Because I'm going to teach you some white manners.
Oh, wait a minute.
I'm going to beat him, and I'm going to beat him white.
That is despicable. Wait a minute. Hold on. No, wait a minute. Your man can't come out here and say he's going to paint a black man white. That is the most disgusting thing.
Well, I didn't say it. He made the shout.
You are his manager. Are you going to support what he said?
He's his own man, dude. And if he makes a challenge, that guy pearl bombs him there, cheap shots him, after he already beat Jabber in 10, I know we'll beat him in 10.
That is the single most disgusting thing I've ever heard, that a man would challenge a black man, and if he wins, to paint him white. Diamond Dallas Page, the Diamond Dolls, and infuriated Colonel DeBeers. Let's go back to Larry Nelson.
Thank you very much, Lee Marshall. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm in the locker room area with Tommy Jabber. We're going to talk about these latest rantings from Colonel DeBeers, but first of all, Tommy,
pile drove onto that cement floor. Are you all right?
Ooh, I got a headache.
I bet. Tommy, he said that he would pin you within 10 minutes. He did not do it. Congratulations.
Thanks. I'm just happy I last the 10 minutes.
Tommy Jammer in a great wrestling match, ladies. Derek Dukes entering the area. In case you missed it, ladies and gentlemen, Derek Dukes, thank God for you. I don't know what would have happened to this young man. Tommy, with the $2,500 that Derek Dukes got. Tommy, I know you're hurting. We'll let you get out of here. Get your head in the ice bucket. Tommy Jammer, ladies and gentlemen. Derek, I don't know how to get into this. This is the most outrageous thing I've ever heard of in my life. Did you by any chance hear this latest thing from Colonel DeBeers?
No, what's that, Larry?
Colonel DeBeers, standing at ringside with Lee Marshall, wants another wrestling match. He wants to wrestle you.
Yeah?
He says that if you win the wrestling match, he will give you $2,500.
Yeah? Okay, go on.
He says if he wins the wrestling match, he gets to paint you white.
You've got to be kidding me, Larry Nelson.
I'm not kidding at all. The man has gone right over the moon, Derek. I've never heard of anything like it. That's the situation. I know you're stunned. Can you give me a response of any kind?
You mean to tell me if I pin him in 10 minutes, correct, I get 25 smackaroos like Jammer just had, right?
Not the same $2,500, but $2,500.
So he'll be out of $5,000, and you're trying to tell me if I don't, he'll paint me white?
That is exactly what he said. He wants to paint you white. Now, I know that this is a ridiculous situation. I don't know. I don't have no idea what to say, but that's it. What are you going to do about it?
Well, Larry, I have a lot of pride in being black.
Absolutely.
And also my wrestling ability. But painting white. I tell you what, Larry. I'm going to accept that challenge, Colonel DeBeers. One stipulation, Larry.
What's the stipulation?
If I pin him in 10 minutes,
right,
I get to paint him black.
Paint Colonel DeBeers black?
That's right. Did you see him going around with a black face, Larry Nelson?
No. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenge accepted by Derek Dukes. Paint Colonel DeBeers black. Derek, this is going to be big news all over the world. We had great wrestling action this week, and before we go, I got people searching all over the building for Colonel DeBeers. I can't wait to talk to
Fillmore, Nelson! Colonel DeBeers is here!
And I've got some information.
Shut up! As you were!
Colonel,
I got some I got some stipulations. Let's get it straight once and for all. Number one, Derek Dukes. 10 minutes.
I know all that.
$2,500. And I will beat him in 10 minutes or less. And when I do, I'm going to paint him white.
I understand.
It won't help. Shut up. It won't help because you can educate his type. It doesn't do any good. He's already educated beyond his intelligence. If the man would attack a bar of soap like he attacked me from behind, he might go somewhere. But there's no way. I am going to paint the man white.
I understand all this. I talked to young Derek Dukes. I told him, 10 minutes, if you do not beat him, you will give him $2,500. In that same 10-minute span, if you beat him, after the match, you will paint him white. Right?
Right. You're Derek, right for once, Nelson.
I've got news for you. Derek Dukes has accepted your challenge, but he added one stipulation.
What might that be?
If he defeats you in 10 minutes, he gets your $2,500, and he gets to paint you black. Ladies and gentlemen, he is having a fit, and who can blame him? We'll find out more about this developing situation next week on All Star Wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for joining us this week on All Star Wrestling. These matches sanctioned by the American Wrestling Association. Join us next week, and we'll see how the Olympians stunned Bad Company and won the tag team titles. Plus more on Colonel DeBeers against Derek Starfire Dukes. You join us next week right here for All Star Wrestling.